A very good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by, as you all know, today you all will appear for a practical test about the Impress Advanced module. In this practical test, you will be asked many questions, answers to which will need to be shown by you practically on your computer. Let us now get to know about the rules for the test. So this class is for your practical test in which you have to show how you will use the options being asked from you. This test will be for 45 minutes. After every question that is asked to you, you will be shown a video about how that had to be correctly answered, and you can check your answer against the video. In case you have answered it wrongly, then you can learn the correct method by watching the video. Let us now get started with the test. First of all, go ahead and insert some slides. Then, on the first slide, go ahead and type your name, class and about your school. Make sure that your name appears in the title bar and you can write your class and school below that. Next, in place of the text, use the gallery option to insert the picture of a school in your slide. Have you all been able to do the tasks you were asked to do? If you have completed all the tasks, then show your work to your teacher. Let us now watch the video and see if you have done this in the way you were supposed to do it. Let us now watch this video for the correct answer. And we have been asked to insert new slides and insert some shapes and write about it. So, first to insert the slide, we go to the slide pane, right click, click on new slide. Keep doing this until you have 5 more new slides. It is a title slide, and on this we want to type a title. So first we click in the title area and we are typing flower, because the first image we are going to select from the drawing toolbar, the flower image, and drag it on our slide. So you have to look for where the flower image is in the drawing toolbar. That is what is happening in the video. Once we find the flower image, we can click on that option to select that option as is being shown here, and then we take our pointer to the text area and drag this flower here. Once it is there, you can select it. If you don't want the text to appear, you just select the contents portion and delete that. Again, go to the next slide. First of all, let's delete the content portion by selecting it and pressing delete. Now you have to add another image here. So go to the drawing toolbar. This time we are selecting star. So we drag the star here. After dragging it, we can select the image and move it wherever we want. Remember, you can also use the green dots to resize to make it bigger or smaller. We are going back to the second slide, flower slide, because we also wanted to write about it. So to write something about it, you need to select the text tool from the drawing toolbar and then drag this small rectangle just below the flower as is being shown, and you can write something about this. You can write this is a flower, or you can write how this has been made, whatever is your choice. So we are writing, this is a flower which is made with the help of circle and curve tool, or which is made by circle and curve tool. So the text is relevant or related to the image that we have made. You should also make an image. The title should be for that particular image. Then we go to the next slide, the star slide. Again here we have to write something about it. So we go to the text tool in the drawing toolbar. We get this rectangle when we drag it here. After selecting the text tool, we drag our pointer where we want the text to appear, and then we can type the text. This is a star. You can even say this is a blue star. We are saying this is a star. And we are writing about how this has been made. So we are saying line tool was used to make this. If you like, you can type anything more that you like about the picture that you have typed. For instance, you can type that there is a poem about the star, Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. Whatever you like, you can type about the image that you insert in the slide. Go to the next slide. Again, click on the contents area. Oh, first we had to write a title for the star. So we go back to that slide, and in the title area we are typing a star as the title. Go to the next slide. Remove the contents area by selecting it and then pressing on delete. Now again we are using the drawing toolbar to select an image. We have selected the rectangle image, or the rectangle tool actually, and using our pointer we drag a rectangle on this slide. Again we want to write something about this rectangle, and also remember to write a title for this slide, because our question has asked us to add 5 new slides, create some image, write a title, and write some text about these. So in this we have given a title saying a rectangle, and using the drawing toolbar's text tool we have now dragged a small rectangle here, blank rectangle, and in this we are typing about the rectangle. You can say that the rectangle has both opposite sides equal, something like that, or like what we are typing here, this is a rectangle, and rectangle tool was used to make this. So we have now so far already completed 4 slides, 4 new slides, besides the first slide which was already there, where we had typed about ourselves and our school. Now we come to the 5th slide. Again we remove the contents area by selecting it and pressing delete. One more time, go to the text, or go to the drawing toolbar. Select an image of your choice. We have selected the cloud tool or the cloud option, and we have dragged a cloud here. Again, let's use the text tool to create a small rectangle and write about the cloud, and then also remember to write a title for this slide. So we are saying this is a drawing of the cloud. And in the title, we can simply say cloud. or if you like, you can say blue cloud. Go to the next slide. Again, we are removing the contents area by selecting it and pressing delete, delete key. We are using the drawing toolbar again. Remember, you can also use insert and pictures option to insert some drawing or picture from your computer. This time we have selected the cube and we have dragged the cube here. We will write the title. We can say a cube, and then using the text tool from the drawing toolbar, we will drag a small rectangle and write about the cube. We can say a cube has six sides. We can also say the Ludo dice is a good example of a cube. Here we are saying this is a drawing of the cube. So this way we have completed and answered this question. Next, use the point option to make a rectangle from it. After making the rectangle from it, show it to your teacher and then watch the video for the correct answer and match your own answer with it. Let us now watch this video and see how we can draw a line and then using points make a rectangle from it. So we've taken a new slide, gone to the drawing toolbar, selected line and drawn a line. Next, we have to use points to make it into a rectangle. So we go to edit, go to points, select points, and you can see edit points, a small menu bar appears for this. So if you want to add a point, click on insert point and insert a point here on the line. Then we want to move point, so click on move points and drag this point, the first point, vertically upwards as is shown here. Then insert point again, click on insert point and insert a point here. Then again move point, and then we can move this point from here horizontally like this, so that we are getting a shape of a rectangle made. Again, we have to insert a point, so we click on insert point option, insert a point here so that it will be a complete rectangle. Then go to move point and move this last point from here and join it to the first point so that we make a nice rectangle. So we have just used the line tool and the points to make a rectangle on our slide. Now go ahead and show how you will change the color of one of your slides. Do this with the help of the style and formatting options and then show this to your teacher. Watch the video for the correct answer and understand how the style and formatting option is to be used. Let us watch this video and see how we use the style and formatting option to change the background color of our slide. We have selected the first slide and then we go to the format menu, click there and click on style and formatting. From the box that opens, select the second icon here, which is for presentation slides, and select background. Then right click on background and click on the modify option. So you can see here it gives you an option for area fill with color. If you select color, there are many colors here. As you can see here, when you scroll down, select one of the colors of your choice and click on OK. And then you can close the style and formatting box. And you can see that the color that you had chosen as your background has been applied to the slide, to this slide as well as to the other slides in your Impress file. So this is how you can use style and formatting to change the background color of your slides. Next, change the format of the picture that you have drawn. change its line style, its color, the color of its outline, etc. Show this to your teacher. And then let's watch the video for the correct answer. Watch this video now and see how we were supposed to answer this question about using the line and filling toolbar to change the format of the shapes on our slides. So we first select the shape or the slide. We have selected the flower slide, second slide. Then we select the image in it because we want to change the format of the image. We select this line and filling bar and we are changing the outline color. We have changed it to black. We can increase the thickness by using this portion here. And then we can change the color inside by selecting the color from the drop-down box or drop-down arrow. Next slide, we have gone and chosen the star. We have selected that image. We have changed the line outline style. We have changed the color of the outline also, as is being shown in the video. And then if you want to add a color, or we are using, if you want bitmapping, a different kind of style in it to fill it in, we have used that. Go to the next slide, which is for a rectangle. Select the image of the rectangle. Use the line and filling toolbar to change the outline color to red. We have increased the width also, and then we are filling in the rectangle with a gradient of our choice. We select on gradient and then we select on the drop down arrow and select one of the gradients or the styles of our choice. Next slide is the cloud slide. We select that. We select the cloud image. We have changed the outline style. We have changed the width of the outline from the line and filling toolbar. And we have also changed the color of the outline. And we are also changing the color which is filled inside the cloud to a bright brownish color. Next is the slide with the cube. We can select that slide also. Just to practice one more time, select the image of the cube. Go to the line and filling toolbar. From the colors option, we are choosing gradient this time. And we click on the drop down button and choose one of the gradients which we like. So this way, we can change the format of our images in our slides using the line and filling toolbar. Now, give some comment about these drawings. And besides changing the writing, also show how you will change its formatting, like font color, background, highlight color, etc. And then show the same to your teacher. Next, watch the video to check your answer. Let us now see how we can answer this question to give comments on our slide and then also to format the comment itself. So we have chosen the second slide, the flower slide. And after selecting the slide, go to the insert menu in the menu bar. Click on insert and then from the options, choose the comments option. As soon as you choose the comments option, this box for the comment appears and you can type your comment here. It can be about the slide or it can be something which will help you during your presentation. So we are typing about this slide or about this class. This is Impress class. And we are also typing another line. Since this is a practical test, we can type about that also. This is a practical class or practical. Now, if we want to format the comment itself, the statement that we have just written, if you want to format it, select this, select the statements, select the writing, the text, and then right click on it. As soon as you right click, you have an option B for bold. So if you click on B, it becomes bold. Once again, right click. If you want to make it italics, click on I. If you want to underline it, click on the U. So you can change the format of the comment itself. So this is how you can give a comment and change the format of the comment. Next, use the custom animation option to change the effects on the pictures in these slides. Show how you will apply the entrance option, motion path, miss effects on your pictures. Make sure that you set a time on the slide also. And then do a slideshow and show the same to your teacher. Let us watch the video and learn about these tasks and also correct our answers. Let's watch this video now. In this question, we've been asked to apply custom animation to our slides. So we select the first slide. There is an image of books here. So we will select that image because we want to apply custom animation on the image of books. So we select this image and then we have to go to the slideshow menu to apply custom animation. Select the books image in the first slide. Take your pointer to the slideshow menu. Click there, as you can see in the video also, and click on custom animation. A box opens on the right side. Since you have already selected an object, the add option is there. Click on that. And now you have many options here for animation. Entrance, emphasis, exit. So any of these animations that you want to apply, you can select that. You will see the effect happening on your slide. Once you are satisfied with the animation that you want to apply, you can click on OK. And this animation gets applied on this image. Go to the next slide. Select the object here, which is a flower. Again, click on add. We are already in custom animation. Click on add. And this time we are selecting from emphasis, the types of animations. And we select one which we like. So we can click on these animations and see it being applied on our image in the slide. Once we like what we see, we can click on OK. And this custom animation gets applied on this image. Go to the next slide. Apply animation here again, the one which we like, and click on OK. So this animation gets applied on the image of the star also. Next slide is the rectangle. Again, we select the image of the rectangle, click on add, and then select the animation of our choice. This time we are using motion paths. This is also a type of animation. Select one and click on OK and it gets applied on your image. One more time, the next slide is for a cloud. We select the image of the cloud by clicking on it. Click on add and then select one of the animations. Again, we are using motion paths and we have chosen one of them, circle. And we click on OK. So this animation also gets applied on the cloud. One more time, just to practice, the last image is cube. So we select the cube, click on add, and this time we are choosing from miscellaneous effects animation. Select one, and if you want to change it, we can change that also. And we click on OK, it gets applied. Now, to see all these custom animations, you can run a slideshow by using F5 shortcut command or by clicking on the slideshow in the slideshow menu. And when you press the down arrow, you can see the animations being applied on each of your slides. So you can see all the custom animations that you've applied to all the different slides will show in the slideshow. So this is how you will be using the custom animation in your Impress presentation. You can see different slides here. All the animations are being applied on them. You can come out of the slideshow by pressing Escape. Now, all of you take a new slide and using the standard toolbar, provide a link on it to another file. Show this to your teacher. Let us now watch the video and check your answer and correct the same if required. Let us watch this video now and learn how we can attach a link to another file on our Impress slide. So first, select the slide on which you want to apply the link or the hyperlink. We have selected the first slide. Then you can directly go to the hyperlink icon in the standard toolbar. Click on that. A box opens. Click on Document. And here you have this yellow icon for Open File. Click on Open File so that you can go to a location on your computer from where you want to select the file for which you want to attach a link. We can go to Pictures option and you can select a picture from here. Remember, you have the option of looking at the address bar and clicking on any of the options or locating the file that you want to choose. So we can go to Desktop, we can go to Documents, or like we are doing, we're going to Pictures, and from Sample Pictures, we are picking the penguin picture and clicking on Open. So the link gets applied in the hyperlink box. Now you can type a name in the text area with which you want the link to appear. You don't want the link address to be appearing. You want some text to appear. So we are typing Computer Shiksha here. Click on Apply and then click on Close. So you will see that in your slide, the link has been applied with as the name Computer Shiksha. If you take the pointer on it, a hand appears. Hold the control button down with your left hand and left click on it, and it will open the picture or the file that you had applied a link to. So this is how you can use the hyperlink to link any file to your Impress slide. Now make a menu bar with your name and show how you will insert options in it for copy, paste, save and slideshow. And then show this to your teacher. Watch the video to check and correct your answer. Let us now watch this video and see how we can customize a menu with your name, with a name on it. So let's select the slide, or actually we just need to go to Tools option, Tools menu, and click on Customize. It opens a box. You can use this to customize menus, toolbars, anything. Since we want a new menu, so we have in this menus, we click on New and we get a place where we can type the name for this new menu. So you can type your own name, or as is being shown in this video, we are typing CS in this. Now we have in the menu contents, it is blank right now, there is no content. So we have to click on Add. As soon as you click on Add, it shows different categories that you can add to your menu. So we have chosen Edit category, and from the commands of Edit, select the one which you want. For instance, we have chosen Copy, click on Add, and that gets added to our menu. Next, we want paste also, so we scroll down, look for paste, select that, click on add. And you can see this also gets added to your menu. Again, we can choose different categories and different commands that we want to include. So we are including other commands here. For instance, cut. So we choose cut, select cut and click on add. Cut also gets added to our menu. If we need some more, we can look in the categories. There are many categories here. For instance, drawing, format, documents. So we select the one which we like, which we want. And then from the commands, we will select the commands that we want to include in our menu. So we have now selected documents. And from within documents, we are selecting the commands that we want to include in our menu. For instance, we want to include save. So we select save, click on add. And that gets added to our menu. One more time, we are going to the drawing toolbar and we want to, or if you want to choose some other tables, graphics, so we can choose whatever we want. Even from the OpenOffice macros, we can choose the commands. Go to view, because from the view category, we want to add another command, which is slideshow. So we select slideshow and click on add. Now you can close this box and you will see that all these commands that you wanted have been added to your menu. And as soon as you click on OK, in the menu bar on top of your slide, you can see that after help menu, a new menu which is called CS, which is the name that you had given to the menu, has got added. If you click there, you can see the options that you had added: slideshow, copy, paste, cut, save, all of them are there. This is how you can create a menu. Now use your name and the words impress test and save your file on the desktop with this name. Let your teacher check this. Now I would request all teachers and trainers to check if all the students have completed the test. In the next class, you will all appear for a written test for this advanced part of Impress. You will be given many questions and all of them will be of multiple choice type. All of you must remain present for the written test. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.